Hello everybody, welcome back. This is
Chapter 3, Continents and Oceans. Looking ahead, in this lesson, you will learn about globes and maps, the four main directions, oceans and continents. As we learned in the earlier chapters, the Earth resembles a very huge ball. It is so huge that we can only see a very small part of it at one time. If you see the globe, you cannot see the full globe at a time. You can only see one portion at a time. So let's study about it. Globes and maps. A model of the Earth called a globe shows us the whole Earth. We can rotate it to see different places. However, a globe is not big enough to show all the places in detail. Yes, you can see this globe as it rotates. You can just see one area at a time. You cannot see the whole Earth. It has limited explanations. There's no complete detail. To solve this problem, we have drawings of a part of the Earth. Map, you have drawings. It is with color, so it has explanation or the whole of it. Such drawings are called maps. Map can be big or small. We can hang a big map on a wall. We call this a wall map. So this map that we have drawings, colors and information, we can hang this on the wall. That map is called wall map. A book of small maps is called an atlas. Maps and atlases are now also available in the digital form.
Currently, we have coverage in over 75 different nations. When zooming in on Italy, you can see different colors representing different feature classes for the parks and protected areas.
Meaning, this book, atlas, it has number of maps in it in a printed form so that you can carry it as a book wherever you go. It is very helpful, especially for traveling. It gives you more information. Directions on a map. There are four main directions. They are north, south, east, and west. If you stand facing a map, the top of the map is north. The bottom is south. To your right is east and to your left is west. So when you stand in front of a map, what you see up is the northern side, the north side. What you see down, that is the south. What you and that you use for eating, E-A-S-T. Remove the S, so it is E-A-T. So you can remember it in this way. The right hand, the right side of the map is the east. And W-E-S-T is the west. West side of the map. You will see the direction north marked in most maps. These directions help us to locate places on a map. Oceans and continents. Look carefully at the world map on this page. You will find that some area in the map are in blue while others in the brown. So if you can see this map, see carefully, there are places which are printed in black and in blue, and there are color brown. So the places in brown, they signify they are land, and which is in blue, that signifies that it is water body and the oceans mentioned in blueprint. The blue area shows water bodies and the brown area shows landmass. A very large landmass is called a continent. A very large body of water is called an ocean. So remember these two. The blue color is and large, that is wide area of landmass, is called continent, and large area of water body is ocean. There are seven continents in all. They are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia, and Antarctica. The smallest continent is Australia. You can see below on the right side, you see Australia, small one. Yeah, this one that I'm showing you, it is the smallest continent of all. It is Australian continent. The largest continent is Asia. Where is Asia? You can see this above. It is Asia. It is the largest continent of all. Continents are further divided into smaller parts called countries. Yes, these continents are divided into small country. India is a country within Asia. The name of our country is India. And we belong to which continent? Asian continent. There are five oceans. They are the Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Southern Ocean, and the Arctic Ocean. The Pacific Ocean is the largest. So among the five oceans, the largest ocean is Pacific Ocean. And which is the smallest one? It's the Arctic Ocean. Oceans are very deep. The ocean floors are not plain or flat. They are long mountain ranges and trenches on the ocean floors. Trenches are deep, narrow ditch inside the sea. A sea is also a large water body but is smaller than the ocean. So ocean and sea, they both are water body, but the smaller portion of water body is called the sea and the large part is the ocean. Don't get confused. Sea is small, ocean is large. Did you know, for a long time there were only four recognized oceans: the Atlantic, the Pacific, the Indian, and the Arctic. Then in 2000, the International Hydrographic Organization declared the Southern Ocean as the fifth ocean. This ocean stretches south of the continents of South America and Australia. And did you know, a compass is used to find directions. Sailors use a compass to find their way while sailing. A compass looks like a watch. The needle of a compass always points to the north. So olden days, they still practice using compass. So this compass, the needle always shows the northern direction. Whichever direction you turn, it will still show you the which side is the north. If you turn again the other side, it will still show you which side, the northern portion, it had earlier shown. So this is very useful, especially if you go inside the sea areas where it is covered with water all over around you. And this is the only way that you can know which side is north, south, east, and west. Fine?
Important.
That's about this lesson. Thank you for listening. Do listen to this a couple of times and you will be thorough with this lesson. Thank you. God bless you. The sun rises.